My father, Atticus, always told me never to bother a man named Arthur Radley. Little did I know that one man would play such a huge part in my life. October night when my brother and I experienced the moment that would change our lives. We were innocently meandering home after a pageant in our small town Macomb. I had forgotten my shoes inside the auditorium and were walking home by ourselves under no light. Jem was the first one who heard the rustle of leaves behind us, suspiciously ceasing to sound whenever we stopped to listen. All of a sudden, we found ourselves running away from our unknown follower. In a matter of moments, we were both on the ground, struggling and screaming. It wasn't until we were back home, Jem's arm broken, and our stalker Bob Ewell dead, that I realized that someone had stopped him. We were just two children. Our only crime was being the children of a man who defended a black man in court. This man, our father, had made Arthur Radley out to be a dangerous fool. Little did he know, he would be the one to save his children's lives. The court date was what I remember the most. We knew that Arthur Radley was our savior, but we also knew that making him testify could be just as good as killing a mockingbird.
Yes, that's the last person said. Mr. Stanley.
Please rise. The court of Macon County is now in session. Honorable Judge Taylor presiding. Everyone may be seated for the jury.
Please take your seats. Will the defendant please state their claim?
Not guilty.
The defendant will not present their case.
I will ask to call Jem to the witness stand.
That you shall give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
Where were you on the night of October 31st?
My little sister's down by the pageant. I had to take her to.
You two were just walking by yourself?
Yes, sir.
Was there anyone else with you when you were walking home?
No, it was just us two. We thought Cecil was there.
So why did you think Cecil was following you?
We thought it would be funny to scare us like.
So other than Scout and Cecil, no one else was around?
No.
Okay, so tell the court what happened that night.
It was dark and we couldn't see anything. We were fine until we heard something behind us.
So what happened when you didn't hear anything?
We kept walking.
What happened next?
Someone launched at us. I just tried to get Scout away.
So you couldn't see anything?
No.
Thank you, Atticus. Now the prosecuting attorney will not stand the witness.
Did you get away yourself or do you not remember?
Someone gave me away.
Okay, would you recognize them if you saw them?
No, it was just too dark.
How did your sister Scout get away?
I don't know.
As you can see, jury, our witness does not recall the events that happened that night. Therefore, he's not a reliable source.
who I'm going to have to ask her to turn to your seat, please.
The other seat, who?
I would like to call Scout to the witness stand, please.
The defense calls Scout to the witness stand.
Do you swear that the witness that you shall give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? So help you God.
Do you see anything the night you and Jim were attacked?
No.
Who else was there?
I call Arthur Redley's and see.
Do you swear the evidence that you shall give shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
Okay, Mr. Arthur, where were you the night of Halloween?
I was walking up on the
What was that night, Mr. Arthur?
Kids.
What did you do after you heard those kids?
Helped.
So do you define helping as killing Bobby?
Objection!
Yes, and we're hurting the kids.
I think that'd be enough evidence for the jury to decide.
Mr. Adler was locked up for nearly 25 years, and he decided to come out just to murder Bob Ewell, as he said on the stand. I know you will make the right decision.
This man was trying to help save the kids. Without him, the kids would be dead right now. He did society a good favor. I hope you guys take that in great consideration.
Has the jury reached a verdict? Arthur Radley, will you please rise to receive your sentence?
The jury finds Mr. Arthur Radley not guilty on self-defense. This case is now closed.
Okay, again.
I smell like cheese.
Wait, I would do
already? Oh, already.